Whatever anyone says, there are magic things in the world. It is sometimes hard to see the magic, but magic things do exist. And this is the story of Annabelle and her magic accordion named Baby. Annabelle was a little girl from Louisiana who came to New York City. She had great big dreams, but no money. The story of Annabelle and her accordion began at an accordion store called Wally's. There were many beautiful accordions there, and they all had names. Wally was very proud of his accordions because he had made them himself. The accordions were like his little children. People came from all over the world to see Wally's store. Sometimes Wally would stay up all night working. He used special tools to make the accordions pretty. When he was done, he had a little drink and played a little song, and the accordion music floated out the window and into the street. Annabelle often came to the window and listened as Wally played. She wanted an accordion of her own, but she was terribly poor. She lived in the street and wore a dress of rags. Wally stayed up night after night working on a special accordion. He said, "I will make this accordion so beautiful that all the children will love it. It will be the most beautiful accordion in the world." Wally spent hours and hours gluing diamonds and sparkling jewels all over the accordion. He worked while everyone else was sleeping. And as Wally polished and carved, he said, "My father would be very proud of me because this is the most beautiful accordion ever made." And then he fell asleep. While he slept, a fairy princess flew in the window and sprinkled magic dust on the accordion. Soon it was ready. The magic accordion was called Baby. Now Bouncy, the rough and tough little everyday accordion, was in awe. He looked at Baby and he fell deeply in love. He had never seen an accordion so beautifully formed, so white and so shiny. But most of all, Baby had a lovely sound, and when she played, everyone felt nice and good and happy. When Baby opened her eyes for the first time, she looked at Bouncy, and she fell in love at first sight. She thought Bouncy was the most adorable little boy accordion she had ever seen. Wally picked Baby up in his arms tenderly and kissed her, as if she were a little child. And then he began to play and sing. Annabelle was listening. She was overwhelmed with the beauty of the sound, and she knew that this was a very, very special accordion. Wally, the accordion man, was so happy at night, playing and working on his instruments. But during the day, his wife would shout at the accordions and tell them what songs to play. "Why don't you play the song they play on the radio? No one wants to hear these beautiful old melodic songs. Wally, you're wasting your time on these stupid accordions." She flashed her terrible eyes and gnashed her terrible teeth, and she flew into a rage. She said, "Why do you spend so much time on this particular accordion? It looks vulgar, all covered with diamonds. No one wants something like that. You are a stupid accordion man." Wally started to cry. Bouncy cried, and Baby cried, and Annabelle, who was listening outside, cried. Baby was terrified. She was only 1 week old. She just was not used to this kind of stress. She felt badly that she got Wally in trouble, and she said, "Maybe it would be better if I just went away. I am scared of Mrs. Tingle. She might rip my diamonds off and throw me in the garbage if I stay here." So when the store closed, Baby hopped off the shelf and quietly opened the door. She went out all alone into the big city. Baby crossed the street on the crosswalk. She waited for the light to change from red to green. And when she saw the green word, "walk," Baby walked. She looked both ways with both of her sweet little eyes, and she was very careful. Baby walked and walked with her little in and out sideways step, and she didn't go very far at all when suddenly she realized she was lost. And Baby began to cry. Strange men were looking at her. A teenager picked her up for a minute and then put her down again. Baby was hungry. She didn't know where to go, and she was starting to miss Wally and Bouncy and all her friends very much. Just at that moment, Annabelle was coming down the street. She heard the sound of an accordion crying.
She heard Baby, but she couldn't see her. And then she saw the accordion hiding behind a mailbox. Annabelle picked up the cute little accordion and started to play. It was as if they had known each other for their whole lives. They sang,
"You are my new best friend now. You pick me up when I feel down. You are the nicest girl in town. You are my new best friend now."
As soon as Annabelle began to squeeze the accordion, a strange thing happened. She started to move up, up, up. Annabelle began to fly up into the air,
over the rooftops.
She was sailing over the ice cream clouds into the bright blue air. And the next thing she knew, she found herself in France, where everyone loves the accordion. The French said, "C'est bon cette petite jeune fille qui jouait au accordéon." They said, "Annabelle, where are you from and why have we never heard of you before?" Annabelle told the folks in Paris, "I am just an ordinary little girl from Louisiana, and this is my accordion named Baby."
The French people said, "C'est super, tu es le chien. Nous adorons les accordions."
Which means, "We love you, Annabelle." Annabelle played and played, and everyone danced. And while Annabelle was squeezing, all of a sudden, out of the accordion popped a bunny.
And then out popped a large pile of money.
The French said, "Oh la la, she is a genius."
And then Annabelle started to feel very funny. "Goodness gracious," she said, "what is this?" And Baby the accordion just smiled and said, "Squeeze me again, squeeze me again." Annabelle looked in the mirror, and she noticed that overnight she had become a big star. And she found to her surprise that just by thinking of a thing while she was playing the accordion, she could make it happen. Annabelle said, "I think this is a magic accordion, and I must take very good care of it." She walked down the street with the accordion on her back like a baby, and she was very glad to find herself magically back in New York City.